Okay, and now I'm going to tint these culverts feathers. Thank you. No. I'm gonna come back and lightly tint . Actually, I'm going to use a larger brush for doing this so I can deliver better. So I've got all of these white, warm white highlights that I've put on this bird. And I've screwed this up before and put too much of my tint on top, and I've lost all my detail. And either had to do it over or just forget about it, and I don't want to do that again. So just warning you that it can happen, but this white is just a little too much right now, and you can see that I've got a very, I'm going to first do these wing culverts and just tone. Those whites down. Makes more difference than you think it would. You can see that now. Do the same thing on the other side. It softens everything. I'm going to pull this right into the what I've been working on in the hallway. Give it a nice tint. Okay. Now I'm going to do the same thing. And you notice how I'm cleaning my brush off. I do not want to have too much paint left on the brush. So I'm going to do the same thing on the head. It's not much, but it is enough to tone things down. And going over this softens the paint to a certain point. So you want to use a very, below it, so you want to use a very soft brush when you come in and tone these things down. Now see how much paint was there? There we go. Small, small amounts. Make sure and get underneath. Okay, that's good for the head for now. Do the same thing with the breast. Got more territory to cover here. It doesn't feel like it's a lot. But in the end, it really is enough. Let's put it that way. Mm-hmm. so it's not so harsh. Do this wing again. Let that dry. Let's do the same thing for these primaries. Things toned down. Now for the underside of these dark tail feathers. Again, you don't want to overdo it. Alright, we'll soften things up considerably. So, yesterday I tinted down the feather detail that I have put into all of these dark feathers with a really light, thin wash of dark brown. And today, and I also added some to the color lineup, some raw umber, which I used to mix a color as what I needed for the wing coverts. So today I've decided I'm going to add a couple other colors to the lineup. I'm adding Naphthol Red and Hansa Yellow because I'm going to actually start putting the color onto the bill. The pinkish flesh color seen on the bill. So I think I'll just... won't take much at all, and since things don't dry out too quickly on this handy palette, it won't require that I mix up a lot. So I'm just going to start with a couple of drops of both of those, Hansa Yellow and the Naphthol Red. I also would like to, or will need, I'm gonna put a little bit more of warm white where I've been dipping in from, but I'm also gonna need a little bit to mix up this color that I'll use for the bill. And I'll use my small palette knife because it allows me to get in a very small area like we have going on here. And I'm gonna add the color to the white. First I'll start with red and it's gonna give me pink. Now it kind of looks like carnation pink. But as soon as I add a little tiny bit of yellow, oops, things get changed up. Now I just dabbled onto some of my gray along with that. So a little bit more yellow. It's funny because quite often I'll squeeze out about what I think I need. And then voila, I've got it without having to add any more. This time it's a little orange, so I'm gonna add just a titch, not much at all. Oh, well, a lot more than I wanted. And tribulations. Anyway, let's see what I can get after this. I think that's a good color to start with. We'll see how it dries on the bill. Alright, I'm gonna wipe my palette knife off so it's clean and ready for use next time. When I'm doing the detail on the bill, and I'm gonna need to take a different picture up on my reference. Let's see if I can find it quickly. Here we go. It's gonna take a few coats, and I am going to be using one of my old blending brushes. I need to go get one. Okay, these are my blending brushes. I use them primarily with oil, but on certain jobs, They work really good for doing the bill and the blending on the bill. So this one's pretty good. And what I'm doing is I'm testing how it will pound the color in. This is another very useful, and it's a little bit softer. I don't even know what brand this was, but it's old and it's worn, and that seems to work out really well for me. So don't throw your old brushes away. These little stubby things can be used to do a lot of specialty jobs. So set these aside, and I'm going to start with the larger of these two blending brushes. And you'll notice I'm not wetting it. I'm going straight from the dry brush onto the palette and picking up some of that color. Now, I see that the color extends up top of the bill. See how nice that blends in by me just stippling it? Which is exactly what I see going on in the real picture. The real bird. You don't have a lot of paint. You can always come back and add more. And the thing that's nice about the deco art is they're the surface is, even after you paint on it, is left open and it's absorbent. So when I'm blending, it's really going in to the paint below it. It's not just sitting on top of it. There's enough moisture in the paint that I don't need to dip it in water to get this nice stippled effect. And this is a pretty dark bill, and I'll be using the darker brown and with a combination of carbon black in the very end. Be sure and stipple it evenly on both sides so you're not wrecking the balance that you carved in by carving it symmetrically. If you can paint that symmetry out by not painting it in evenly, so pay attention to that. Kind of doing a second coat here now. Allows me to adjust the back edges. Want to just touch the front of the bill. I'm sorry, the front of the nostril opening on both sides. It's important to get the paint distributed evenly on the brush, as little as there is, so that, and if for some reason, you know, you hit the surface and you haven't, then just rotate the brush and get that side that's got a little bit heavier paint in other areas, so it's not just on one side. Pay attention. All right. Now, of course, I'll be able to adjust again with the darker color I'll be coming back with. I have to look at it straight on to be able to check the symmetry, and I know that blocks your view, but I'm sorry. As soon as I know it's symmetrical, I can flip it around and do it from behind. A lot of people use an airbrush to do this. I just think airbrush looks like airbrush, especially on a bill. And I just don't see that look on the real bird. And it's a bit more work to do what I'm doing here, but it does pay off in the end. You have the patience. I'm just lightly tapping where it needs more color. After I hit the palette, I come back onto the paper towel and hit there again, because I don't want there to be too much paint on my brush. So I think I need to come up just a little bit here. Now, this is a back and forth effort. And once I get this rinsed out and pretty much dried out, I'm going to come back with this dark brown. Even though it will be darker in the end, I will be coming back with darker. I just want to adjust things a little bit. I could not do this without these brushes as well as I can with them. But you just can't go and buy this brush in the store either. This is an old one. Okay, so you can see the difference. How much darker so I softly just smooth that transition line. All right, so now I'm going to come back behind the bill on the back side. I'm doing the same thing when I meet up with the pinkish, barely touching that edge and going in small, tiny little circles. This dark brown that I'm putting on is darker than the medium brown that I used on the base coats. Once I get this sides done here, take a look at what colors are necessary for underneath. I have a couple of pictures of two drakes that are displaying courtship display, and they're swimming together with their heads up in the air. I'm sure they're trying to impress a female somewhere in the vicinity. It's amazing how much difference it can make just to add this little bit of color. Alright. Well, that's enough of that. Let me get my pictures out of those two displaying drakes in breeding plumage, and I'll be right back. Okay, I got the upper mandible color blocked in. I'm gonna do the same thing under the on the lower mandible. It's not as predominant as it is on top, but it is definitely there. So it's a little more difficult to get in. I know you can't see this, so I'll hurry. This is difficult to get in here. I might have to go to that smaller brush. Maybe not. Don't panic if it's not perfect, because this is just the first pass of the pinkish flesh color. Kind of a salmony, not really pink, it's not really flesh, I should say. Flesh by maybe Crayola crayons definition when I was a little girl in my 108 pack of Crayola crayons with the sharpener on the back. That was pretty special to me. Let that dry a little bit. And I don't know if I can light it up well enough for you to see what I did. But I need to do another, need to do another coat. Before I'll be done. Alright, that helps to see the color on the bill for me. There's going to be several different steps that I will use to create depth in this color and on the bill to make it look like it's fleshy. But for now, this is basically a base coat of color on that bill. Where I'd only done the dark brown before, now I've got that pink. So there's only a few feathers that haven't been detailed out anymore at all, and that would be these on the face, right around the eyes. And I'm going to work on that next. I want to get these feathered out so that I can come back and add some more colors to what's already there. Of course, you know, we're back to the make sure that I can, you know, the different barbs that I'm making here, I want them to show up. So I'm gonna do them fairly. It's hard on these little tiny ones where I'm starting out. But let me get some water going here. There we go. It's just like the warm white that I did on the dark feathers. I'm just doing dark on the light feathers in contrast. And I really don't know how anybody else does it. It's just what works for me. I think there's a lot to be gained by doing this feathering. It really creates softness and texture more as an illusion than anything. Well, it doesn't feel like I'm using up the paint in that little puddle, but I am using it faster than I realize. Getting close to the competition date. Today is my daughter Alexis's birthday. July 16th. And the competition is July 26th. And 27th. So, and it's a full moon. I'm taking advantage of that. I have creative surges during the full moon phases. As wacky as that might sound, you start paying attention, you probably do too. If you have any creativity in you. And if you're watching this, then you probably do. Well, if you get my Oldsquaw article, it explains in words this technique I use. And it might, you know, some people, I think with a combination of these videos that don't show everything because it's either too far away or I've pulled it out of view, you know, I'll be the first to admit they're not perfect because I'm a one-woman production team here. Not only do I set up the camera and manage that, I also produce all the videos with special software. So, if you use that article in combination with these videos, you'll be able to see exactly what I'm doing. All this fine detail that I can't really zoom in on. I don't know if you can see that. But I'm working all in the very front and back on the darker gray. finish up the top portion of the gray. So you can see before, I'm sorry, now you can see before and after, before and after. I'm going to do the other side, and then I'll do the feathers around the eyes, which I guess would be the lores on some birds. And songbirds. Thank you.